Again, welcome. You can stay seated or you can go ahead and lie down and we'll get going. We're talking about God being our rescuer and our defender and our deliverer this week. In Psalm 18:2, it says, "The Lord is my protector. He is my strong fortress. My God is my protection, and with him I am safe. He protects me like a shield. He defends me and keeps me safe." I love thinking about God as our rescuer and our protector and our defender. Certainly, he has saved us from sin and death, but also from so much more. He protects us and guides us to safety. So what do we have to fear? So I want you today in your quiet times when your palms are facing up, just hold in your hands anything that you might be fearful and just send that up to God. Just release that to God in those open hands. So if you're not already on your back, go ahead and lie on your back. Really being intentional about opening up those hands and just releasing from your hands any fears that you might have. Just send those up to God. And just feel the breath move in and out of the body. Let's take three deep breaths here. Big, big, deep breaths. Inhaling into the belly, into the lungs and the chest. And then releasing all the way out. Do that again. Breathe into the belly. Breathe into the chest, expanding all the way up. Open the mouth and release. One more time. Big, big belly breath. Move that breath into the lungs and the chest. Fill it up. Open the mouth, let it go. Starting to stretch, take those arms overhead. Reaching back, pointing your toes, lengthening your spine. On the exhale, bring just that right leg in, interlace your fingers at your lower right leg, squeeze it in nice and tight. And then gently releasing that right leg a little bit away from the body with your hand on your knee. Make some nice big circles here. So circling just into that right hip. Keep your neck long. Focus on your breath. One more circle into the right hip. And we'll gently reverse. Moving intentionally here into the hip, warming up the hip, working out those kinks. Let's take one more. And bring it back into center. Gently extend your right leg all the way out. Reach it back, stretch out your spine, point your toes and lengthen. And exhale that left leg in. Hands at your lower left leg, draw the left leg into the body. Squeeze it in nice and tight, but just beginning to work into that left side now. And then bring that leg a little bit away from the body with your left hand on your knee and circle that left knee around, circling into the hip. Always breathing. Intentional here, and you can make those circles whatever size you like.
Let's gently reverse. Focusing on the breath. Warming up that left hip. Again, working out those kinks. Let's take one more. Bring it back into center. Extend your left leg out. Arms come overhead. Last time here, a big stretch. Reach back. Point your toes. And exhale, knees in. Squeeze both knees in. And this time with hands on both knees, touching at the tops of your feet. Let's take our knees in opposite directions of each other. Make big circles. Nice and big here. Just touch those feet together somewhere, keeping them together by the big toes or anywhere that works. Let's take one more big circle and gently reverse. Be aware of your breath. See how those hips are starting to open up, starting to become more supple. Let's make one more big circle. All right, bring it back into center and drop your feet to the mat. Knees in line with your hips. Let's take the right arm back, left arm forward. And then we'll switch and switch. So just going into that nice big backstroke motion, warming up your shoulders now. Just gently keep switching, go at your own pace. Just reaching back and forward, floating those arms, using your breath. All right, way to go, you guys. Let's take one more on each side. Float the arms back to center, lining up for your bridge pose. So arms at your sides, palms down. Again, just take a quick lift, knees in line with your hips, root down into your feet. We're going into bridge. Lift your hips high. Press those hips all the way up. Lift your chest towards your chin. Okay, hold here for a breath. Really root down into your feet. Lift those hips high. Focus on stretching out the front side of the body. And then gently lowering down your entire spine, a little bit at a time. So with intention, come down slowly. Release the tailbone to the mat. And let's do that again. Lift up strong. Press it up. Again, make sure you're lifting your chest as well. You want that nice arch in your back. This time, let's interlace our fingers under the hips if you want. And you can squeeze your shoulder blades together here. This is a nice chest opener if you want to go for it. One more breath here. Inhale. And release with your exhale. Gently lower down. Take the arms out. And gently release your spine to your mat. Uncurl the tailbone until it's down on the mat. So once it's down, let's lift up again. This time we're going to press all the way up with the inhale and then exhale, lower down halfway, just halfway. And then lift up again. Press it up. That's the inhale, exhale, lower down halfway. One more time, lift up strong, hold here, press it up. Root down into the feet. And with the exhale, lower down all the way. Use your core muscles. Don't just flop it down. Really move down slowly and with intention. Once the tailbone is all the way down, come into your butterfly pose, the reclined butterfly. Knees are wide, hands on the belly. Four deep breaths here, breathing into the belly. Thank you. One more breath here. All right, bring your left knee over to your right knee. Roll over to your side. Stay here for just a breath on your side. And then gently press up.
Super nice. Sit tall. Legs crossed. Take a breath all the way up. Reach it up. Lengthen your spine up. Bring your hands together in prayer and drop it down with your exhale. We'll do that one more time here. Breathe it up. Inhale. Stretch all the way up. Hands together in prayer. Drop it down with your exhale. Sitting nice and tall, we're going to work into our neck. So take your hands to your knees, close your eyes, and I want you to take a really big, slow circle. Just imagine you're carving out a big circle with your nose. Really slow. So being super intentional here. Let's make one more big circle. Really moving slowly as you can here. And then when you complete that second circle, we're going to go the opposite way. Just carving out that nice big circle, really taking your time here, seeing how that neck feels. And then we'll do one more. So as slow as you can make it. And then go even slower. And then bring it back into center. All right, bring that head high. We're going to come into staff pose. So staff pose, legs are out in front. You're on your sit bones, okay? So you're rooted down into your hips. You're pulling the toes back, flexing the feet. Okay, grounding the legs down. Arms at your sides, just take your palms down. Okay, so we're gonna breathe in, we're gonna lengthen up as we breathe in. And as you exhale, just feel those shoulders relax down. We'll do that two more times in your staff pose. Nice big breath in, lengthen up. Exhale, feel the shoulders relax. And one more time, big breath up in staff pose, lengthen up. And exhale and release. All right, nice job, you guys. So take your left leg behind you, bend your knee, bring it all the way back. Go back as far as you want here. And if this bothers you anywhere in your hip or in your knee, you can always come into our seated tree. So if you remember seated tree, your foot is on your inner thigh muscles. You can always take that as an option. But if you want to, bring that knee back. Okay, so just back, as far back as you want, as far back as feels good for you. Keep the foot on your extended leg still flexed. And we're going to take a big breath up. So turn to the middle. Take a big breath up and fold over. Okay, so this really depends on you, how far you want to go. This might be a really deep stretch into that right side. It might be kind of intense, so just be gentle with yourself. Maybe you want to slide the fingers forward a little bit. Maybe not. Maybe you just want to stay where you're at. Maybe you want to drop your forearms. It's really up to you. So we're going to take three breaths here. All right, great job, you guys. Go ahead and walk it back up. So bring that leg in. We'll switch sides. So come back into your staff pose. We'll just take one breath here in staff. Big breath in. And let it go. And then take that opposite leg back. Knees bent. Again, take it back as far as you want to take it back. Your other option, if that doesn't work for you, is to come into your seated tree. All right, so find which one works best for you. Keep that foot on the extended leg flexed. So turn to the middle, take a big breath up, fold over, and to exhale. See how this feels. The side's tired for me. So, you know, notice how it feels and just kind of observe that off if you need to, if it's too much. So let's take three breaths here. Really great job, you guys. Walk it back up and bring that back foot forward. Come back into your staff pose, palms down. Let's take a breath here and let it go. All right, so a butterfly pose. Feel good after that. So bring those feet together, sit nice and tall, and then round your back when you're ready. Drop your chin, gently come forward. We'll stay here for three breaths. All right, super job, you guys. Come up tall, legs nice and wide. Flex those feet. Big breath up, inhale, fold over, exhale. We're getting lots of really great inner groin muscle stretches today. So come down again, same thing, as far as you want to come. Keep your feet flexed. Three deep breaths. Wonderful job. Come on up, cross those legs. So we're gonna make our little chicken wings. So take your hands onto your shoulders. And we're gonna make those nice big circles with our elbows. Really big and slow. Just like we did with our neck. Really intentional here. Big circles, squeezing shoulder blades together and back as you draw those elbows back. One more here, really slow. All the way around. Squeeze it together in the back. And we'll reverse. So we're inhaling as we draw those elbows up. Exhaling as we drop them down. Nice job, you guys. Use that breath. Let's do one more here. Really big, really slow. Bring it back into center. Nice job. Go ahead and shake out your hands and your arms. And we'll find our way onto our knees. All right, so coming into your tabletop. So we're going to start with our cow. We're going to inhale strong, belly coming down, tilting pelvis out, and then finding your cat, round, and exhale. Bring it back into tabletop. Bring your hands a little bit forward. Let's make some big circles with our hips. Press the hips out big. So let's take one more here. So notice which way you're going. Next time we're going to go the opposite way. So come back to your tabletop. Bring those hands back in under your shoulders. Find your cow. Inhale. Exhale, round for cat. So back into your tabletop. So bring those hands a little bit forward and make your big circle. So this time going the opposite way of the last time. Nice and slow. Nice slow circles going on today. Sometimes it's good to just feel what's going on there. Let's take one more really big circle. Just really taking our time. And bring it back into center. Move your hands forward. And take a nice big upward facing dog. So just extending up, stretching out your spine. Pressing into the tops of your feet. We're gonna drop the chin down and look down. Bring the chin up and look up. And do that one more time. Drop the chin down, look down. Bring the chin up, look up. Bring your head to center. Over that left shoulder. Head center, look over your right shoulder. And we'll do that one more time. Come center, look left. And center and look right. Wonderful job. Bring your head back to center. Take your knees wide. Draw your hips back for your child's pose. Head on the mat. Take two or three deep breaths here. Feel that nice rounding in the back. It's a really nice counter pose to your up dog. One more breath here. All right, coming to your tabletop. Just take your right foot back, tuck your right toes. Press in, get that nice calf muscle stretch. Push the right heel back. One more breath here, really press in. And then slide that right foot past the left foot. So keep sliding it until it stops. And then look over your left shoulder and look for your right foot. Just squeeze in those left oblique muscles and stretch out this right side. You'll feel a nice stretch on the right side. Let's sweep it back. Find your calf muscle stretch again. Press in. And then bring your knee into your nose. So rounding the back, knee to nose, exhale. And inhale back to your tabletop. We'll do the left side. Left leg back. Press in. Push the left heel back as you breathe. Don't hold your breath. One more breath here. Stay nice and lifted. Stay strong. All right, let's go ahead and slide it across. So again, just let it go till it stops. Look over your right shoulder. Look for your left foot. Get that squeeze on the right side. You guys are doing great. The love that I had tried to earn was a gift that I soon learned. All right, go ahead and bring it back into your calf muscle stretch. Push back, take a breath, and then we'll go knee to nose. So running back, exhale, knee to nose, and inhale, bring it back into your tabletop. Bring your body up over your knees. We're going to take a big breath up here, inhale, and exhale down. Inhale up, draw it up, exhale down. Inhale up, we're gonna stretch down the right side of the body, so drop the arms down, really stretch down this right side. Sorry, leave your left arm high and stretch over. So we're gonna reach down the right side, look up under your left arm, left fingers reaching towards the right. And let's switch and go the other way. Stretch it down that left side, right arm high. Reach it over. Look up under the right arm. Really stretch down that left side. Feel that nice lengthening on the right side of your body.
Let's do that one more time. Reach down the right side. Reach down that right leg. Left arm over. Nice long stretch. Look up. And center and switch. All the way over. Nice and long. And bring it back into center. Interlace your fingers. Pull your shoulders down away from your ears. We're going to go into a really nice back bend here. So lean it back, open up the chest, drop the hands towards the ground. If you feel like you need to take your knees wider here for a little more stability, that's fine. Keep breathing into the chest. We'll take two more breaths. Release. Find your tabletop. Let your hips sway. Let your head hang in the center. Let your neck relax. All right, nice job, you guys. Press those hips out a few more times. And we'll bring it back into center. Okay, let's go to our downward facing dog. So, just noticing your positioning, noticing your alignment. Toes pointed forward, heels behind your toes, hips are high. We're gonna just stay here for a breath. Really press those hips back as you press your heels towards the mat. And then gently pedal out your heels. So just enjoy the breath, enjoy your down dog here. Stay lifted, keep pressing your hands into the mat, pushing the earth away, push the ground away. Stay lifted, stay strong. We'll come back into center, push into your left foot. Right leg comes high, bring your knee to nose, round your back, exhale. Stay here, and then right foot to your right hand, runner's lunge. Get some movement here in your runner's lunge, forward and back. And then come back to runner's lunge. We'll go into our lizard. So opening up this right hip, come up onto the right edge of your right foot. Arms are on the left side, so you can stay up on your hands or you can come down to your forearms. Or maybe you're somewhere in between. If you have a block handy, some people like to use the block here. You have a lot of options in your lizard. This one is a really great hip opener. So we're gonna stay here for a few more breaths, wherever you are. Find your way back to your runner's lunge. Left knee down, crescent pose. Here we go, take it up strong. All the way up. And then open up to cactus arms and let those arms fall all the way back and around and take it all the way back up. Hands to prayer. And do that again, cactus arms, open it up. Let those arms fall back. Sweep it all the way around, back up to cactus. Sorry, back up to crescent. And then we'll bring the hands to the mat. Sit it back for your half splits. Draw the right toes back. That really nice hamstring stretch there. Take one more breath here. All right, so back to your runner's lunge. Let's come back up to our crescent. We'll do that again. So bring up those palms together, open it up, cactus arms, let the arms fall back, sweep it around, take it back up to crescent, and do that again, cactus arms, sweep it around, take it back up to crescent. Release the hands to the mat, find your half split. Pull those right toes back, pull the body over, draw the belly in, breathe. Nice job, you guys. Find your way back into your runner's lunge. Tuck your left toe, right leg back. Dip back into your downward facing dog. Gently walk it out. Pedal it out. God is our rescuer. Let's push into your right foot. Take your left leg high. Bring your knee to your nose. Round your back. Hold it here strong. And then left foot comes forward to your left hand. Runner's lunge. Again, just working into this left side here. Moving forward and back. And then we'll come back into our runner's lunge. And we'll go to that lizard pose. So you're coming up onto the left edge of your left foot. Arms to the right side, you're up on your hands, or you're on your forearms. Again, this is a great place maybe for a block. This is a deep stretch into those hips. Nice hip opener on that left side. Let's take a few breaths here in our lizard pose. Way to go, you guys. Release wherever you are. Come back to that runner's lunge. Bring your right knee down. Come up to your crescent. Stretch it up, palms together, and then find those cactus arms. Open it up. Let those arms go all the way back and sweep it all the way back up. Crescent pose, and then cactus arms. Open it up. Sweep it all the way around, back up. All right, hands to the mat. Great job, you guys. Let's sit back for half splits. Pull your left toes back as you fold over. It's our rescuer, our defender. Let's take a few breaths here in your half splits. Lovely hamstring stretch. Forward, find your way back up to your crescent. Let's do that again. Nice and big. Take it up. Cactus arms. Open it up. Sweep it around. All the way back up. Cactus arms. Open up. Sweep it around. Back up to crescent. And release. Hands to the mat. Sit it back for your half split. Hold those toes back, draw that belly in. Give yourself a little more space here. Keep breathing. All right, back to your runner's lunge. Great job, you guys. Tuck those right toes, left leg back, downward facing dog. Take your legs wide. Let's take a big heel lifter here. So heels come high. Push heels down and push hips back. Do it again. Inhale high. Stretch out your feet. Exhale. Push it back. One more time. Lift those heels high. That amazing stretch. And then we'll exhale and drop those heels down. All right. Bring your feet in for your downward facing dog. We're going to go to warrior one. Take your right leg high, three-legged dog. Circle your right foot and reverse. And bring it back into center. Bring right foot to right hand. Rise up strong. Warrior one. All right. Nice job, you guys. So we're just going to take a really simple warrior one today. We're going to take a side angle stretch. Right hand down, left arm high. Back into your warrior one. And that's it. Bring your hands to the mat. Right leg back, downward facing dog. Lift your left leg high. Circle your left foot. And reverse. Bring it back into center. Left foot to your left hand. Flip out your back foot. Warrior one, sink in. And then going into your side angle stretch, left hand down, right arm high, all facing away from you. It's nice and simple. Come back to your warrior one, hands to the mat. Left leg back, downward facing dog. Go ahead and take your flow here. So coming into your plank, elbows pointed back, lower down. Over or up dog. Exhale to your downward facing dog. All right, we're gonna do that again. If you guys need a break, remember child's pose is always available. Right leg high, circle your right foot. And reverse. Right foot to your right hand. Rise up to warrior one. Sink into your pose. Side angle stretch. Right hand down, left arm high. Rise back up, warrior one. Hands to the mat. Right leg back, downward facing dog. Keep breathing. Left leg high, circle your foot, and reverse. Left foot forward, warrior one, rise up strong. Sink into your pose, side angle stretch. So turn that body to the side, left arm down, right arm high, look up. You guys are doing great. Remember, you can always take a break if you need to. Back to your warrior one. Hands to the mat. Left leg back, downward facing dog. Go ahead and take your flow or go straight to your child's pose. All the way back to down dog and then child's pose if you're not already there. Right. Head on the mat, nice deep breaths. This is our rescue story. Never gives up on us. Isaiah 46:4. Love this. It says, even to your old age and your gray hairs, I am he. I am he who will sustain you. I have made you and I will carry you. I will sustain you and rescue you. Such comforting words to know that God will carry us. Even through our old age, no matter what we have to go through, he is there. He is strong. He is able to be our rescuer. So nice deep breaths here.
I will send out. It's true. I will rescue you.
Let's take two more breaths here.
Cannot be covered over and over. You're not defenseless.
Come on up, find your tabletop, and then your downward facing dog. Take your right leg high. Find your warrior two pose. Right foot forward. So rise up strong to your warrior two. Look over your front middle finger. Check your back arm. So we're gonna lengthen this front leg. We're gonna turn to the left, bring your arms high. And then take your arms to cactus and pull it down strong. And then we'll drop back to our warrior two and do that again. So turn left, arms come high, take palms together, and then cactus arms, make those fists really strong, draw it down, and then back to your warrior two. We're gonna do it two more times. Lengthen, arms high, cactus arms, find your warrior two. One more time, cactus arms, take it high, and then take it to your cactus arms. And then find your warrior two. All right, cartwheel hands to the mat, right leg back, downward facing dog. Let's take that flow, find your plank, lower down. You can always drop your knees. Cobra, or extend all the way up for up dog. Downward facing dog with your exhale. Push into your right foot. Take your left leg high. Left foot forward, warrior two. Flip out your back foot. Drop those shoulders. Check those arms. Check your feet. So we're gonna lengthen that front leg. Bring those arms high. Turn to the side and then make those nice cactus arms. Really strong. And find your warrior two. So do that again, lengthen that front leg. Arms come high, that's your inhale. Exhale, bring it down strong. And find your warrior two. Let's do it two more times. You guys are doing great. Lengthen up. Strong cactus arms. Feel that strong upper back. Find your warrior two. And one more time, inhale up. Cactus arms, really strong. Find that warrior two. Way to go, you guys. Cartwheel hands to the mat. Left leg back, downward facing dog. Go ahead and take your flow, however you like to take it. Or go straight to your child's pose. All right, so everybody comes to child's pose. Let's take our arms to our sides this time and take the left side of your face to your mat. And just let the head and the neck relax, let the shoulders relax. Just breathe here in your child's pose. Take the other side of your face to your mat. Just flip it over and rest. Now bring your head back to center. Bring your arms forward. Take your palms up. So palms up. And again, with your head down, just placing any fears that you have in those hands and just sending those up to God, your rescuer, your defender. A couple more breaths here. All right, there you go, everybody. Come on up. Find your way on your belly through spine strengtheners. So we're going to do bow pose today. So bow pose, take your hands right below your toes, okay? And another option here, if you want to, some people like to grab their ankles. And if you're doing that, flex your feet, okay? Or grabbing below your toes, pointing your toes. Okay, if neither of those work for you and you want to grab your pants, that works. Or just flex your feet as if you were holding the ankles in that pose. Okay, so we're going to come up, bring the chest off the ground, bring the gaze up. So again, if you've got your ankles, flex your feet. If that doesn't work, just do whatever you can go with it. Okay, again, maybe grab your pants, lower legs, anything that works. So nice arch in your back, press your heels up, or point your toes more. If you're holding right below your toes, really push those feet away. So bow pose.
Take it whichever way you want. We'll take one more breath here. Inhale. And we'll release with the exhale. Drop it down. Arms to your sides. Side of your face or head to your mat. Feet splay open. Just relax and breathe. Allow the spine to reset, strengthening your back, creating a more flexible spine here. So let's take a couple more breaths as we just let it restore. Chin back to the mat. So let's do it again. So options are, take your hands under your toes, point your toes, your hands at your ankles, flex your feet, or just grab your pants, or just bend your knees and send them up. Okay, lots of options. Take whichever one you want and just really go for it. Keep breathing. Okay, try to lift that chest away from the ground. Maybe bring your gaze up. Either pressing the heels up or pointing those toes strong. Let's take one more breath in. And release. Exhale. Take it all down. Take the other side of your face to your mat and relax. Just simply breathe here. Take one more breath. Bring your head back to center. We're going to go for a quad stretch. So come on to your left side. Right hip comes over the left hip. Left arm is out. You can just rest your head on your left arm. Take your right foot and your right hand. And focus on this quad stretch here, the front side of your right leg. Okay, if your knee is really high, go ahead and drop it down. You want to try to get your thighs parallel. And then really push your foot into your hand. Again, if your foot's not available, just grab whatever is available and make it work for you, getting that nice quad stretch. Awesome job, you guys. We'll take a few more breaths here. Really pushing foot into the hand. And we'll release. Roll on your belly on the other side. So come up onto your right side, right arm out. Bend the left knee. So same deal here. Push that foot into your hand. Or grab the pants or whatever's available. Keep the knee low. That left knee is low. Stay with your breath. Take one more breath here. And gently release. Roll back onto your belly. Gently press up. And find your way to your back. All right, nice job, you guys. So bring your knees into your chest, which is a nice counter pose for that spine strengthener, that back bend you just did. Great job, you guys. Just roll, rock and roll, right and left. Roll it out. And then bring it back into center. We'll go to our twist, left leg out. Right knee over the left side of the body. Right arm out. From belly in, keep breathing.
let's release. Right knee out to the right side. Open up your right hip. Squaring off your shoulders. Keeping your left hip down. Keeping your neck long. We'll take a few breaths here. Really nice, you guys. Bring that right leg in. Gently extend the right leg on the mat. Bring your left leg in. Find your twist. Left knee over the right side. Look left. Just think of all the great things you did for your body today. So many nice chest openers. You worked into those hips. Great job today, you guys. Here comes my little furry friend. My old furry friend. All right, one more breath in your twist. Go ahead and open it up. So bring those hips back into center. Left knee out to the left side. Nice big hip opener here. Just breathing deeply. And we'll take a couple more breaths. Left knee in, bring your right knee in, draw your knees into your chest, find our happy baby, take the arches of the feet, draw the knees down, make sure your tailbone is down, everything is down on the mat, on that back, top to bottom of your spine is on the mat, and then we'll move. Closing the eyes, turning up the corners of your mouth into a big smile, recognizing that your God rescues you from trouble. He carries you, he's your protector. Let's take a few more here. Just breathing as you move. Back into center. Drop your knees into your chest. Squeeze it in. Arms come overhead. Stretch it out. Lengthening. Take a big fist with your hands. Point your toes. Stretch your spine. Stretch your shoulders. Release. Exhale. Hands behind your knees. Knees to your head. Head to your knees. Squeeze it in. Let's do that one more time. Big breath, big stretch back, hands together in a nice big fist. Point your toes. Remember, we're going for that tug of war in your spine here. Lengthening spine. Stretching out the belly, the shoulders, pointing those toes strong. Let's release. Exhale. Bring your knees in, hands behind your knees, knees to your head, head to your knees. Wonderful job, everybody. Release. Walk your legs out. Take your legs wide. Arms away from the body, palms up. Big, deep breath here. Inhaling with a big release, with a big exhale. And then just breathing softly. allowing everything to rest, giving yourself permission to really release here. Noticing your feet and your toes and allowing your feet and your toes to relax. Noticing your legs, left leg and right leg, allowing the legs to relax. All the way up. Noticing your hips, your pelvis, your low back, and your glute muscles, and just allowing all of that to relax. That up your spine, noticing your mid spine and your upper spine. Notice your rib cage as you breathe in, feel the rib cage and let everything rest, let the entire back rest. Now focusing on your belly, focusing on your chest, allowing the breath to move through belly and chest, allowing the belly and chest to relax. Notice your hands. Let the hands and the fingers relax. Hands becoming very heavy. Notice your left arm, your right arm. Allow the arms to relax. Start at the bottom. Notice the elbows and then move all the way up to your shoulders. That feeling of relaxation into your neck. You can swallow if you want to. And then take that up into your jaw. Allow the jaw to relax. Allow the mouth to relax. Allow your tongue to relax. Notice your cheeks, the muscles around your eyes, all the way to the forehead. Allow it to all relax. Just give yourself permission to let your face really fully relax. Allowing your entire head to relax. Your head becomes very heavy, just sinking into the ground. And then take a quick scan and just notice if there's any areas where you're still withholding that you haven't fully released yet. And just pay attention to any of those areas. Being very intentional about releasing. Letting go. Bringing your thoughts to our sweet Lord. Noticing those palms facing up. Thinking about whatever you may have placed into those hands. Remembering these beautiful verses. Psalm 18:2, the Lord is my protector.
is my strong fortress. My God is my protection, and with him I am safe. He protects me like a shield. He defends me and keeps me safe. Let's take a moment here as you rest, as you breathe. Those hands open, releasing any fears to our great Heavenly Father, our wonderful protector, our provider, our defender, our rescuer. Let's take a moment here and then we'll finish up with our prayer. Good job, friends. Let's gently bring back some movement. Roll out your wrists or turn your head side to side or wiggle your toes. Let's bring some movement back and then roll over to your side with your knees bent. Stay on your side for a breath or two. And then fully come up to your seated position. Sitting nice and tall. Great job, everybody. Let's go ahead and bow our heads in prayer. Here's Heavenly Father God, we're so thankful, God, that you carry us. Your strong arms carry us through the storms, through the chaos, through the confusion and the fears. We thank you, God, for being such a strong protector and defender and rescuer. We thank you for taking our fears away from us today that we have sent up through our hands. We just thank you for taking that, God. We know you're big enough. We know that you will always be there for us. We're thankful for your presence. We're thankful that you are willing to die on the cross for us and take the punishment of our sins. You brought us mercy. You brought us grace. I thank you for my beautiful students, and I pray this practice has blessed them top to bottom, inside out, that they feel refreshed and renewed because of you. I thank you, Lord. We give you all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. You're an amazing God. You're an amazing defender and protector, and we love you. In your holy and very precious name that we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, you guys, thank you for joining me today. God bless you all. I hope you had a wonderful practice. I hope you have a great day. Try to stay cool. I don't know, just stay inside. That's all we can do. If you have a pool, you're lucky. We don't have one. So thanks, you guys. I can't hear anybody. Is everybody unmute? You can unmute yourself.
Thank you, Beth.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Hi, Jerry. I haven't seen Jerry in a while. Hi, Jerry.